What a beautiful morning. What a beautiful day. We are out there on Mr. Brown's farm. It's so much happiness here. The hummingbirds are flying around. The roses are blooming. Sun is shining. Birds are singing. You know, the battery is loaded, and then you can paint. If you feel good, you're excited, it's a happy day going by. I think I will paint a seascape right here on Mr. Brown's farm. Okay, I put the magic light on already. I don't want to just spend time putting magic light on. So from now on, you think the canvas is wet. I will have a happy little seascape in the wind, and I will use a kind of a lizard crimson color, Prussian blue, Taylor green. So, and now we will see. Let's fire in. That kind of a sea color. See, that green, the turquoise. You must always think turquoise colors, they are in swimming pools, and it gives you that feeling of wet. See, and make it so this is a kind of a stormy weather. So again, the same color, alizarin crimson, Taylor green, Prussian blue, and you fire in, and sing loud, be happy, because with the happy tune, you can create so much better. If you're miserable, there is a miserable painting left. Yeah, it can't help sometime. This you are not feeling too good. But then don't paint. I think we should not... creative power is such a sensitive thing, you know. You have to... I always, before I paint, and I know today I can do a good job or I goof. See, I condition the whole canvas now in that color. The whole canvas. See, that kind of a turquoise color, Taylor green, comes out a lot. So use more Taylor green. It gives you a beautiful, and a touch of alizarin crimson. See, now you... There you are. No, we will. Maybe here a little bit more greenish, turquoisey color, a bit more water. I always feel water is in the air when I have that Taylor green. Now I will create, I take my almighty brush, that big, big fan brush, and then you think big, and I will create a light. It's always nice to have a certain light there. See, now yellow and white and a little touch of red. I would say here is kind of a whatever. See, start off and bubble out. Oh, isn't that wonderful? It's always nice to be alive and you can think happy and you think fresh. That's a happy little day going by. No, not a little day, happy, powerful days gone by. Again, white, yellow, see, always just grab it like this. Fire in that light, I need that light there. I can fire in that light right there, see? Can you see already rhyme, rhythm, harmony? And you're right in it. Your blood is pulsing right. Your pulse is going right. There's no problem. Again, just once more there. See, I need that little bit of light in order to really, really let that dance in there. See? Now you can use your big brush, a clean brush. Make sure you have a dry, clean brush. Dry, clean brush, and hypnotize from the light into the dark. Something like this. See? See, now that light will make your painting. That light will make your painting. I will create a kind of a wave movement, the same teal green, passion blue, a little crimson. Form it. There are so many ways of forming your wave. I would say here. There is dark. See, I see it already, which way the wave should come. See? Almighty. Let the water roll in this way. See, think about the oceans. We live on two oceans. There is the Pacific and there is the Atlantic, from sea to shiny sea. And there are two different waters. The Pacific is rolling in, and the Atlantic is shopping in. So with those kind of words, I think you can do quite good. See, now the next, I will create. Now this, let that water, let the wind blow high, let the wind blow low. See? And don't be fussy. See, roll it like you would say waves. Can you see already waves rolling in there? Oh, let it boil. See, that's why they prepare that light in the back. The water is rolling in against the light sky. If you have a dark sky, then I would have a light water. See, you try to find a contrast. Contrast. See, and don't worry too much on the side. You can make it even darker there. Same passion blue, teal green, a little crimson, and whatever you need dark now, I would say come in from the outside. There can be more dark. But let it roll like waves. Give them certain, it is organized, because waves are really organized. Because they come, the next one. Yeah, you would think, why the devil you are out here in the land and paint a seascape? Yeah, you know, sometimes you need excitement and the sea is too far to drive down. What you do, just load the battery with whatever you can find. And I thought Mr. Brown's farm is just so beautiful out here. There's such a peaceful piece of land here. And Mr. and Mrs. Brown, they are such peaceful people. And it gave me that almighty peaceful, oh, fire in. There's a better tomorrow. And then it depends on how far you want to go back. See how far you want to see the seascape. Let the wind be in. See, let the wind be in there. So now we will. I will use a second brush. Why the devil I clean it so much? And have a light, have always, it's nice to work with that. A lighter brush with light colors and another brush with dark colors. Then you don't have to wash out so much. See here a little twist. See, smaller in the back. See? Small in the back. See, already, this alone is already a nice little seascape. See, if you want to paint a vignette, you can just leave that and frame it, and it looks good. It will look good. Now I will turn the water over here. See, here I would like to. See, the light is from the back coming in now. That means we have to create kind of a top. On top of that wave is the light. The below is dark. See, I try to get the paint on first. Watch how I do it. Take it off here with a touch of yellow, maybe a little touch of red, and have that kind of a Yeah, that's a nice color. And now just put the paint on. You see, I just dabble it on, but the fan brush is good. The fan brush gives you figures. See, look. See, good. Now the next step will be, you grab this paint and twist it over like this. See? Very light stroke. Hey, that's a big roll. A big roll is coming up there. Now then, underneath, see, that's why we painted dark there. Now you can make it more dark. Taylor green, Prussian blue, and Alizarin crimson. And see, that gives you a dark, dark color there. Dark color there. See, you must think, this is in the shadow. The light's coming from the back. See, and then you... Have a dark, have it more dark. Have it more dark. As more dark you have, as easier you can fire in things. Taylor green, Prussian blue, and Alizarin crimson. Have it dark, have it dark. See? Dance it in whatever you think of it. See, that has to be sometimes senseless, but it's really not. As looser you will paint, as more you get the water right. See, you can create a kind of a, see what I do here? I would say there is kind of a... So, now the next step will be to use your white again. Now think, the water is coming, turning over here, and it goes so far. Turning over, make it nice as you see it really turning over. Now, all of a sudden, it hits, it's already very shallow there. It hits the bottom, and it will, I show you what it will do now. It will beam up all of a sudden. Ring. See, look at that. That's the same, can you see? Now it's coming around, hits the bottom, and beams up again. It beams up again, like a wild horse. Like, and see how you do it? Look, try to break that brush. See? This has to be... You have to study that, because it never works the first time, right? But think, it's rolling over, the light's coming from the back, it must hit the top, the light will hit the top, it must be shed in the front, but then, see here, watch, this should be dark again. Watch this. See what I do? Leave that rim light, and then dark again. See, let it boil. See? It's like a big cloud, but make it dark again. But leave the top. See now? Can you see how? And then again, water, you know, water is bouncing off. You can create a stone and have that stone. We will do that, I think. We should. See, and then again, it gives another little ripple there. And the fan brush is just the best for that. And let it fly, let it fly. See, put the wind into that. See? Isn't that beautiful how you can create a happy, see, the perspective, right? Small in the back and then come forwards, 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 bigger, bigger, bigger. And then you can have it in so many ways of rolling out there. If you want, you can have, I use black here in this case, and touch of white, and Prussian blue, and tail, see, now I blank out. You know what you expect when you're 70 years old? I live in crimson. Maybe the time will come where I don't remember my name. Then I shouldn't be out anymore. Okay, we just can create a kind of a, oh, almighty stone there. See, there. More black, Prussian blue, a little crimson. And you fire in, always with light and shadows, like you paint the mountain scene, same idea. See, let the light, you work with light and shadows again. See, and this can really make a nice, nice scene there. Watch. Hey, look at that. Now we will ply that water, you know, we will ply that water on that stone. See, and that gives you extra one again. And that stone, the water is wet. Water is wet. The sand is wet, and it will reflect in the water, in the sand there. See, pull that down. Pull that down like this. You see, pull it down like this, right into the water, and add a little touch of red and yellow, and start off here, and come in, because think about wet sand. It has a kind of a red and yellow, red and yellow. See, now you highlight that again with colors you would think sometime red and white and yellow and whatever you would like to see in a stone, whatever you like to see in a stone. Maybe that's a good color. Now I can highlight, think that this light that hits here, hits there. It's there, maybe here, it's there, fired right into the sand, here. See? And see, you must think the light hits from the back. And here, whatever, just movements, like water running off. In the water, the same. In the water, the same. Just have it. See, something like this gives you a nice water feeling. Here's a big brush. Brush it out like this. So you create kind of a water feeling there, see, brush it out like this. Now when it's wet, then you really can dance into that, and you would create kind of a, see, I use the heel, the other side of the knife, see, this corner of my knife, and pull in something like this, and make a curve if you want to. See there. Then mix it nice and wet. Mm-hmm. See? Nice and wet. And then pile up a little bit of white. Just white because it turns with the colors. And then the next step would be you move this up. See, move it up. That means the water is running off. See, can you see it, the idea? Move it up, and that goes like water is running down. Water is running down. Then you use your fan brush again, and you create kind of a little bit of a water dancing there. See? Good, good, good. See, and when you push this, you push long lines, what makes it nice too. Just long lines, something like that. Now we will create here a little bit of just movements. See, maybe closer to the sun, a bit more light. See what we do here, take up white and yellow, and maybe here we add a little bit of, just where you think the light would hit. Just movement, and wind and whatever you put in there, and that's good. See, now we come to this side. On this side, we will do nothing. We will do nothing. We will just create, let that water run out here. And it will look like this. See, have it in here already. Let it come forward. Look how I use my brush, the corner of the brush. See? I wouldn't worry too much there. Just darker movement. Let the water dance there. But the light should be concentrated in the center, where you have the center. See, that's why we build it up like that. See, here you can have other little rolls, other little, it slows down. Can have it like this, but have distance there between. See, it is wet, it is moving. See, no, we will put more power in here. That means white and yellow. See, that is brighter. Put more power in there. See, that's what will make your painting. See? Hey, good. And here, maybe here, a little bit. Now you could put all kinds of animals in, driftwood, whatever. If I had more time, we could do all kinds of things, you know, we could, but make it alive here. See, this is for your eyes here. Put it alive there, maybe. I like to break up that long line there. See the nice harmony, rhyme, rhythm? It is just working beautiful. It works good like that. Now you can use your knife and put some that looks good. Maybe here a bit more. Just in the light. Always pull it together, then it's wonderful for your eyes. Pull it nice together. And we get a happy little seascape. See? Like I said, you can put all kinds of animals in there, or driftwood, or, you know, on the water. Sometimes I paint a painting, I say the Navy had a party out there, and they had bottles and everything is lying on the shoreline all of a sudden. It all came on land. So, again, wash your brush. Make sure you have a clean brush. Make sure you have a clean brush. Pull it along like this. See? And now you put a couple happy seagulls in. There you have to be very solid if you do that. Thank God I still can do it. I still can do it. So it's not too bad with me. And smaller than smaller you have them, that means they have a distance. This one is far away. They come closer. See, we will make one more. This one is quite close. The next step would be now, you just use a touch of white. Maybe the best would be magic white, a thinner white. See, like this. And put some nice little tips in there. See how it looks? Okay, and that's it. A happy little seascape. Enjoyed it? Thank you for watching me.